Dear students, the company had passed a resolution to spend 1 lakh rupees every year on education, but it was not implemented. Okay, but the changes, the reforms made by the William Bentinck. So in that connection, the company, East India Company, had passed a resolution to spend 1 lakh rupees on India for every year on education. But in terms of reality, it was not implemented. It was not granted. It is finally an education committee was formed during the time of William Bentinck. Okay, an education committee was formed under the involving of separate Indian rulers in the year 1834. Lord Macaulay, okay, thought of introducing English education in India. He got, okay, for his benefits of British East India Company, Lord Macaulay, reformer, thinking of introducing English education in India because it was not prevalent before that. However, the educational method advocated by Macaulay could not benefit the youth. Okay, what he introduced, the Indian youth did not get much benefit of this English education. Indians lost the advantage of acquiring the ancient knowledge. For that, okay, previously, the greatest knowledge of Indian Vedas and other things of knowledge, okay, Indian got lost of our own acquiring knowledge and skills developed by their ancestors. What they, our ancestors, okay, our fathers, great-grandfathers, all the things which acquired, they experienced, all the things they lost due to this method. The method of British education system was opposed by a number of intellectuals and, okay, Mahatma Gandhi called it as they give a millions of knowledge of English just to enslave them. Okay, that is the thing that our great people of intellectual, they oppose this English education system. If our youth got learned all this in the English, our previous tremendous knowledge will be lost and we got into dark. This Mahatma Gandhi also called it as they give millions in knowledge of English is to enslave them. Okay, we can enslave these British people, okay, by the receiving English education. We have enslaved the nation. Okay, later, three universities were established in 1857, but the British could get educated workforce due to the introduction of English education. Okay, the motive behind this introduction of English education was not the benefit of Indians, it is benefit for the own people of English education. For that, if Indian learned English education, they learned all these things, it will beneficial for them to utilize these Indians and to for their own benefit. So this is the motive of British. Alongside, it also developed nationalistic thinking among the educated Indians. Many machines were invented in facilitate to the industries, transport and communication, considering the convenience in running and administration of strategic importance for the military. The Britishers introduced the railways in India also. Another thing is that for their own benefit, India, British, they also introduced railways in India. So these are the reforms which was introduced by the British for their own benefit, not for the benefit of India. In order to maintain an effective control on the country and to exchange messages with the neighboring territories, modern methods of post and telegraph were introduced in India in 1854. Printing press and circulation of newspaper grew alongside. These reforms were actually for the convenience of the British, not for the Indians. But it turned out to be a blessing in disguise for the growth of nationalism in India. The class that acquired the English education spread-headed the social reforms and nationalism in India. Since they were more familiar with the contemporary development in the world around, the post and telegraph brought, okay, people closer. Actually, these reforms introduced by the British people, it is a beneficial in disguise of, okay, for the growth of nationalism. Really, after that period, all educated people came to contact the idea thought due to the introduction of education. Okay, for that reason, they are understanding what is going on around the world. For that reason, okay, this social reforms became Indians to prepare for the fight against the British, that is called freedom fight in future. That is the thing. So finally, dear students, I'd like to summary all this chapter. Diwani rule: after acquiring a rights to extract revenue from state like Bengal, Bihar and Orissa, the British started extracting maximum revenue from peasant, thus making them poorer and poorer. Moreover, lakhs of people starved to death during the terrible famine that Bengal witnessed in 1770. Governor General Lord Cornwallis enforced Permanent Settlement Act. Warren Hastings was given the job of collecting revenue, so he called a collector. The British policy of social reform made the people feel insecure. They feared that the government was trying to convert them to Christianity in order to destroy Indian religion and culture. The next thing is, people believed that the Indian social system was deliberately undermined in railways and the military. An order was passed in Agra that every Indian had to salute the British. Indian handlooms supplied clothes to the markets of Europe and Asia. European traders came to India for business. Indian jute, silk wood and cotton were in high demand. Finally, in 1834, English education system was started with the help of Lord Macaulay. Mahatma Gandhi said, to give millions a knowledge of English is to enslave them. Finally, dear student, the reforms were introduced by the British for their benefit, but they benefited Indians too. But still, those reforms became a blessing as the emotion of nationalism was inculcated in the minds of Indians who were brought closer with education, newspapers and post and telegraph. So these are the chapter, Effects of British Rule in India. I hope you better understand. Thank you.